This lesson is called Move It, Move It. Together, we're going to write a program to get our friends from the starting spot with the compass rose to the smiley face goal.
Okay.
But the smiley is face down, and only one person knows how to get there. Let's get this program started. A program is an algorithm that has been coded into something that can be run by a machine. Most of us think of a program as something that we write for a computer. Programs are really good for that, but they're also helpful in other places. You can make your own game or even program a robot to do things for you.
Today, we're going to learn to program using a drag-and-drop language called Blockly. Blockly uses colorful instructions called blocks to build programs that you can use to solve puzzles. Under the hood, you're still creating code. Each puzzle you'll solve with the code is split into four main parts. On the left is the play area, where your program will run. In the center, you'll see the toolbox area that holds all the blocks that you will need for each puzzle. To the right is your workspace, where you will drag blocks to build your program. Finally, above the workspace, you will see the specific instructions for each puzzle. Don't worry if you accidentally drag out a block that you don't need. If you have an extra block, simply drag it back into the toolbox to put it away. After you hit run, you can always hit the reset button to get your character back to the start so you can try again.
Use your head to hold your hat, and your smarts will tell you where you're at, and to think about the zoo, and to nod hello to you and you. Use your head when you're online, to keep what's yours inside your mind, and to know how to be safe. how to give your life some private space from your head down to your toes. Pause, think about it from your feet up to your nose. Pause, think online. Use your heart to grow and grow, and to give yourself a healthy glow, and to make a Valentine when it's not okay from your head down to your toes.
This is a fantastic lesson called My Robotic Friends. It's a lot of fun. We teach programming without using computers. So we get groups together where people program their robotic friends to stack cups in a certain configuration just by drawing arrows on paper. So right now we're implementing the activity that they've been working on. We had a programmer who wrote down this program using arrows, and we have a robot who's reading the arrows to try and figure out what they need to stack using the cups. So she'll translate the arrows into specific movements to try and make one of these stacks.
Programming so that they make the character move in the direction he's trying to move.
And the other person is the navigator.
Be respectful.
Don't be a bossy navigator because nobody likes a backseat driver.
Here, why can't you do this?
Wait. Hey, stop that. Give it back. Wait, that's not nice. Give it back.
Just one thing.
Communication is key to successful pair programming.
No. You can't say something after.
You and your partner should always be talking.
Okay, so
wait a second.
All computer scientists, no matter how experienced they are, run into errors that they need to fix. This is where debugging is to find them. Gateway. Everything looks good with the first block of code.
BB-8 needs to pick up each to move BB-8 on that path.
Bubble,